Father, who is this person?
This, my child, is Saint Ignatius of Loyola, a person whose life and work will make you, over the next few years, a young man of upright character and outstanding accomplishment, beyond academics, towards human excellence. About the year 1515 AD, there lived in Spain a young nobleman. He was handsome and brave. He was Ignatius of Loyola. He thought of becoming a great general, of winning many battles, and earning glory and fame. He would attend many parties and dreamt of marrying the daughter of a king and then living happily for many years.
Pienso que un sueño parecido no volverá más. Y me pintaba las manos y la cara de azul. Y de provisa el viento rápida me llevó. Y me hizo volar en el cielo infinito. Sueño parecido no volverá más. Y me pintaba la mano y la cara de azul. Y de improviso el viento rápido me llevó.
One day, the French troops invaded Spain. They took town after town till they reached the town of Pampeluna. And within the fortress, there was Ignatius, sword in hand, ready to fight. Ignatius was wounded by a cannonball and was taken to the hospital. He had to spend several months in this hospital.
Yeah.
To while away the time, he asked for some books to read. He was given books on the lives of saints and the imitation of Christ. But he simply refused them, as he wanted romantic novels to read and nothing else. But finally, as no other book was available, he began to read the lives of saints. This reading completely changed him. He thought, if others could become saints, why not I? What great and noble deeds the saints did. Why not I? And he made up his mind to become a saint. He went on a pilgrimage to a church at Montserrat. There, he prayed the whole night and consecrated himself to Mother Mary by promising her to live as her knight. As a sign of this, he offered her his sword. As he wanted to work for God alone, he renounced all worldly pleasures and put on a cassock. He spent his time praying and preaching the truth. It is then that he wrote The Spiritual Exercises, a book which showed people how to pray and how to find God. To become a priest, Ignatius had to study. He went to the renowned University of Paris. There he met Francis Xavier, who wished to become a rich and famous man. Ignatius would often tell him, "Francis, what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world but loses his soul? No matter how rich or famous a man may be, if he sins, he will not gain eternal life. His riches and fame will be of no use." At first, Francis Xavier did not listen or care at all. He only mocked at Ignatius. But one day, he understood that Ignatius was right, and so he decided to become a priest. Eventually, Francis Xavier became a saint. His miraculously preserved body is at Bom Jesu in Goa. Ignatius made other friends who were ready to work for God. They formed the Society of Jesus. The motto of the society is AMDG. It stands for Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam. It means for the greater glory of God. They took the vows of poverty, of chastity, and of obedience to their superior. The chief aim of the society was to work for the eternal salvation of man. The Jesuits would go to the hospitals and care for the sick. They helped the poor and the needy. The Jesuits are responsible for the education of thousands of young people belonging to every social class, community, and religious group in all parts of the world. Jesuit education is inspired by the vision of a man and is drawn from the life and the teachings of Jesus Christ. It is also based on the principles of character formation. Beyond academics, towards human excellence.